Chapter 4, A Bright Idea. At 3 o'clock in the afternoon, the boys climbed down the ladders and stretched out the grass to rest. Then they cleared up the brushes and headed downtown to find some cardboard boxes. Sonny towed his old toy wagon behind him with a clickety bang. By 4, they were back. They stacked the boxes on the porch by the kitchen door. Sonny went off to watch cartoons, and Ernest went to their room to pick up the phone. In a few minutes, he appeared with the driveway of his room with a big smile on his face.
"Psst! Sonny, come here!"
He signaled to Sonny. Suddenly hesitated, but finally pulled away from the TV. Ernest locked the door behind them and motioned for Sonny to have a seat. He pulled out an index card from his pocket and spoke in a loud, excited whisper.
"Look at this, Sonny. I called the TV station, and guess what? We can get a 30-second commercial slot for $50. It'll be shown 3 times. Oh, $50? It's not so bad. I got 25 in my secret box.
Me too. Now all we gotta do is come up with some commercial," Sonny said, catching the excitement from his brother. Then his face fell. "But, we don't know anything about commercials, do we?" Ernest waved his hand.
"We can learn.
The lady at the station said you can show anything as long as it's not dirty. So it's not like to win any prizes or anything like that.
But I say we do something better than anything that's some stupid girl commercial."
"Well, we can try. We gotta try something unless you want to live in Kansas City."
"Oh, okay, let's go for it. But I sure hope this works."
At supper time, the boys and their mother were already at the table. Mr. Wheeler clomped into the door. He set a small cardboard box on the counter while he washed his hands. Then he turned and squinted at the boys.
"What do you call these little boxes for?"
He picked up a box.
"What do you mean?" Ernest replied.
"You said to collect boxes."
Their father shook his head and frowned. "You call these boxes? These match boxes? What can we pack in these? Paper clips? We need big boxes for moving. Big boxes."
His voice was gruff and tense. Then he sighed and took a seat at the table. Mr. Wheeler said the blessing. Then everyone ate in silence. The boys glanced at their father from time to time to check his mood. When he was full of roast beef, he seemed to calm down. He gave a weak smile to the boys and said, "Your paint looks real nice. Real nice." The boys smiled uncertain smiles.
"But, what's all that sand doing in the ground?" the father added.
Ernest shot a glance at Sonny, and Sonny began to choke on his mouth.
Sand? Oh, sand. That sand. I think
there's a colony of ants moving in out there." Ernest hid a smile with his right hand. Mr. Wheeler grabbed the newspaper and jerked it open.
"Ugh, mighty big ants if you ask me.
Somebody must have spilled a truckload of sugar to attract that many ants." Then I quickly got interested in his paper. Sonny began to breathe more easily. With the meal over, Sonny and Ernest lumbered into the living room to watch TV with some ideas for their commercial. None of them appealed, so they quickly set off.
"Nah, also something kind of funny. I like commercials that make me laugh."
"Me too, but what? We could do our Laurel and Hardy routine, like we did for Cherry." Ernest sneered.
"Nah, I'm tired of them."
He thought a minute. "Why don't we do one of those commercials with the salesman tells a bunch of lies about the car, only everyone knows it's lying." A gleam came into Sonny's eye.
"Yeah, it might work. I could be the liar and dress up real crazy like. And I could be the straight man. I'll wear the dark suit."
"You work out the script," Sonny said. "I'll check the attic for clothes." All of a sudden, their mother called them from the kitchen.
"Sonny, Ernest, on the double."
The boys looked at each other curiously and aimed themselves toward the kitchen. The mother started in the doorway, pointing at the kitchen floor.
Do you two know anything about this?"
Her blue eyes searched their faces for the truth. The boys stared at the floor. Tiny circles dotted the floor under the table, leading away to the porch door. Sonny knelt down and closed the blue stains.
"Oh, it's that stupid cat!
He must have gotten into paint and trekked into the house when the door was open. I'm gonna drown my crazy out." Miss Wheeler glared at him.
"I don't think the cat is the one who left the door open," she reminded him, and Sonny blushed.
Sonny scurried up to the footboard to the steel wool pad. Then he and Ernest went to Sonny's room to do some more thinking about their commercial. When they had their idea all worked out, Ernest stood up and stretched.
"Ugh, let's go back downtown
and look for some more boxes, before Dad pops in a Terry." Sonny moaned and stretched out on the bed. My heart's not in it, he said with a sigh. It's not fair to make us collect boxes when we don't even want to move in the first place. It's cruel and unusual. I know, but we gotta get Dad in a better mood somehow. Sonny dragged himself off the bed. Okay, let's go. While Ernest searched the vanity store, Sonny went inside a TV and appliance store. In a few minutes, Sonny came out, backing out of the side door to such an enormous refrigerator box. The box swayed and rocked him back and forth as he pushed it, then pulled it, bumping into a fire hydrant and parking meters as he went. Up ahead, he could see Ernest with four nice boxes already a block away heading home. He continued to push and pull the box, but it kept on falling down and bumping into things. He stopped inside the club for a moment. He raised a box over his head and brought it down over him. He was now inside the big box, standing up. It was dark and hot, but he took his pocket knife and cut two holes for his eyes. With his face pressed to the eye holes, he started shuffling down the street. As he crept along, he could see people pointing at him and laughing. But he didn't mind. No one knows who's in here, he said. So who cares? Suddenly, he had nearly caught up to Ernest. When Ernest saw him coming, he slapped himself on the forehead. Oh no, I can't believe it. Why'd I have to be related to him? He got a fresh grip on his boxes and took off running for home as fast as he could, leaving Sonny far behind.